Cascadia 2011
with DD15
engine on that. It was something wrong with the coolant system and something wrong with the coolant by itself. It was losing the coolant and it was building the pressure inside the system, so it's exploded the tank. So to find out what's going on, we use that device. That's a pressure test cooling system pressure kit. It has all coolant tanks, caps, shapes you need to have, and has a small pump with the gauge on it. So what we did, we pumped the pressure to 5-6 psi, ran the engine, and we found out that under the pressure we have a coolant leak coming out of somewhere under the radiator. So assuming that the radiator is bad, right now it's putting out of there because it's the system under the pressure. So when I'm dump the pressure, but if I've done the pressure, I'll do it right now. When we dump the pressure, it's kind of stopped. It will stop leaking right now. Fuel. So assuming that truck need to be need the new radiator, because there is a bleeding hose from the tank, and there is no more other pipes, the coolant pipes, so it's definitely leaking directly from the corner of radiator. Since the radiator is plastic, probably it's no good anymore. And again, it wasn't leaking before we dumped the pressure, before we pumped the pressure, before we pressurized it. As you can see right now, it's not even pouring, it's just leaking drip by drip. It means if you're not gonna use that device, you're not gonna find out that you have a coolant leak. And another strange thing with that truck was that we couldn't get the pressure built in the tank. So looks like the pressure was going on at home. So that was the main problem. So now we're gonna change the radiator and then do that test again to see if it's stopped leaking.